I've had this Yamaha MU50 sound module for about 25 years. I like it. Everything was going great until earlier this year, the power adapter failed on me. I ended up trying to find a brand new sound module in the year 2021, and I bought an S engine sound module. It was very similar to this Pianobox Pro, except it didn't have the dial on it. I had mentioned in the video when I started the machine up for about 10 or 15 seconds, there was a high-pitched whine. I thought it might be defective, so I was going to exchange it, but I didn't actually exchange it. I just got a full refund because I noticed on Amazon.com that they had power adapters for the MU50. I didn't know if this power adapter would work or not. I thought maybe the polarity could be reversed, maybe the voltage is a little bit different, and I thought that it could damage the unit. But I decided, since this power adapter is shot and is never going to work again, I might as well take the risk because I'm not going to be out anything. But this power adapter ended up working just fine, so my MU50 sound module was up and running again. I wasn't sure if that particular sound module I purchased was defective or if that's the way they all sound in the year 2021. So I went and purchased this Pianobox Pro, which is about $120, maybe $130. I forget exactly how much I paid for it. But the S engine one that looks just like this was only about $78. It was a lot less expensive, and it was actually a little bit better than this particular unit. I wouldn't recommend any of them though, because there is a lot of background noise in them compared to this Yamaha MU50. Now, if you read reviews, some people will mention that these can be problematic, and some people say, hey, I don't have any problems with it. The people that say they don't notice any noise at all might not have another MIDI sound module to compare it with, because this is dead silent, where this particular Pianobox Pro and the S engine sound module that I bought earlier, about 7-8 months ago, do have much more background noise than this particular MU50. As you folks can tell, the display of the MU50 is much better than the display of these new MIDI sound modules. The way the MU50 is laid out, you can use the buttons to navigate really super easy to show you access to all the MIDI channels or change parameters like the attack time or the decay time and several other parameters as well. With these new MIDI sound modules, I noticed you don't have access to all those parameters. The only cool thing I like about the new MIDI sound modules is that they have a USB connection. That USB connection will allow you to connect to the computer without the need for a USB to MIDI cable, and it will also supply power to the MIDI sound module. I think that's really cool because, as I stated earlier, my power adapter got fried for my MU50, where these new MIDI sound modules, all you have to do is get a basic USB cable and a cell phone charger, and you're good to go. I want to say that it seems like it would be easy enough to make these old style sound modules from the 1990s have a USB port on them. As you can tell, this doesn't have a USB port. These started popping up in the late 80s, early 90s before they even had USB. But it seems like they could make something similar to this again with great sound and, like I said, revamp it slightly. I think the company that is making these type of MIDI sound modules knows there's a little bit of a need for them, and they're not really too worried about having a Class A product. They just want to get something out there that some people will probably be happy with. But for myself, knowing how clean sounding this MU50 is compared to the newer sound modules that look like this out on the market, I just can't accept the quality that these produce. And I can't accept the fact that this is finicky. Like I said, the notes would continue to hold. And then sometimes I'd hit notes and they wouldn't sound. Like I said, this thing is really just a piece of garbage. And like I said, it could be defective, but I'm not going to demonstrate how to use the drum machine, how to use the different MIDI sound modules that are built into this unit, because it's just not worth it. This is just a video kind of warning people to be a little bit cautious when trying to buy a brand new sound module. It was so easy to buy a good sound module back in like 1993 or 1996. It wasn't problematic at all. Whether you got Korg, Roland, or Yamaha, they all just worked and they work really well. I just want to say that if you have a Roland, a Korg, a Yamaha sound module from the 1990s, and your power adapter fried, you could probably find the correct power adapter on Amazon.com and not have to worry about trying to use these newer sound modules that are finicky and problematic and really don't have that great a sound to them. I just want to say I know a lot of you that have MIDI keyboard controllers will plug into your desktop or your laptop and use plugins like virtual instrument plugins or SoftSense plugins. And that's great if you're near a desktop computer or a laptop computer. But if you're in a band and you're constantly going to band practice or you're playing several live performances each month, you might not want to bring your laptop or your desktop to those performances. I want to let people know that the sound modules from the 1990s can playback music notation from popular software programs like MuseScore and Cakewalk. You could have a Dell desktop computer and somebody could have an Acer laptop and it's going to play back the music score exactly the same. You don't have to worry about virtual instrument plugins or soft synth plugins. And if you're playing live, you're going to get the exact same sound because you're using that same sound module. I also want to say that I know a lot of you use your cell phone as a MIDI sound module. And you can do that if you get the right USB cable, but I myself, when I'm at my apartment or if I'm renting a house, I just wanna tap into the old school MIDI sound modules, whether it was from Roland, Korg, or Yamaha. But it's really just personal choice, and I'm not suggesting everybody needs to have an old 90s style MIDI sound module.